Good morning, everybody. Do you hear me? Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
My name is Gulzena Rastaven, and I am a member of the IFTA Local History and Genealogy section. On behalf of the Standing Committee and our church, IFEC, who unfortunately could not come here today, I would like to welcome you to this conference. It is organized by our section together with Asia and Oceania section, and Laila Hussein Mustafa. She's going to chair the conference. Conference has two topics: local history and genealogy in multi-ethnic societies, the impact of genetic mapping and digitized sources, which should give us more insight into our own multi-ethnic past. We have been more and more aware lately that we are genetically, we do not come from one nation or from one ethnic group. Our forefathers come from different ethnic groups. So maybe it's time to say goodbye to one nationality. We are no more Polish, Serbian, or German. We are a mixture of different ethnic groups: a little German, a little Romanian, and a little Serbian. I myself am 70% Polish, rest is Baltic and Tatar origin. And the second topic accentuates that libraries are not anymore passive institutions, printing books and other writing sources. They have become more and more mediators, producers, and partners in development of local communities and their local heritage. Preserving culture, awareness, and understanding. I would like to welcome all presenters from different parts of the world and countries. Some of you have traveled for many, many hours in order to come here. United States, India, Japan, China, Lithuania, Romania, and of course, from Serbia. Welcome to all colleagues from Serbia. We are happy to be here at the University Library, happy to be in Belgrade, and happy to be in Serbia. Now I give place to Professor Birko, Director of the Library. Thank you.
Dobar dan. That means welcome in Serbian language, but not only in Serbian language, also in Croatian, Bosnian, Herzegovinian, and Montenegrin, and hopefully, you know, most of the region will understand, and Bulgarians will have any problems to understand it at all, and even Poles will have many problems to understand when you say Dobar dan, what you then. Which means just to, in a certain way, give more evidence to what my colleagues said, we are very close. Our histories are intertwined and connected. We are a mixture of everything, and this group, in a certain way, represents that mixture. And I'm very, very privileged, and I'm really delighted that I am in a position to welcome you to this University Library, Belgrade, to this conference that we have been so nicely organized. Thank you, Flav, Steri Kuvidi, Jenna, Ayla, for their effort, and also my colleagues who were here. hours to come and to organize little details. I'm very happy to see you all here. We are part of a larger world, and even that I think myself that history is always local, and that if there is anything that is truly and meaningfully local, then the history is, because it has to take place somewhere, always. And whatever, you know, the global movements and changes and the forces and long way, whatever it is, it still needs to be somewhere, which means there where you live. And of course, I'm an old Heideggerian. I like this Dasein concept that we exist and we are right here where we are. So I'm delighted that you're here, because in a certain way you promote the existence itself when you are somewhere, when you share that with us. Also, I'm Professor of Serbian Literature, and I'm not going to bother you with Serbian Literature, but do use a few moments of your time while you're still around to get acquainted with the local histories, with the local cultures, with the Serbian literature. And Serbia has not distinguished itself in everything. I must say that, even that it makes me really, really sick. But we did distinguish ourselves in literature, and if we were in all respects of our life as good as we are in literature, we would be more or less famous, trust me. And it's not speaking or bragging because I used the literature, it's just that it happened. That the very tiny nation produced very quality symbolic art in the literature. Not in all of course, but in the literature. While you're in Belgrade, try to get us to know us better. And I know that you have heard a lot of things different. Many of you have never been in Serbia or in the region. You have heard a lot of different. And some of them, unfortunately, are more or less true, but not all of them. You will find us wholeheartedly warm people, old-fashioned, traditional, Slavic, with all this kind of spiritualism that is attached to the Slavic soul and the concept of something being slightly rational, but in a certain way easier to relate to, because it's very emotional and things where other people perhaps judge that very rationally. Apply more emotions. But try to learn as much as you can about us, and let us please get to know you better, to learn about you and your countries and your experiences, and especially about your, of course, librarianship skills and your expertise. You came here to teach us, to let us learn about different things. Thank you for that. Thank you for bringing such a valuable package of knowledge and experience here. We appreciate that, and we are looking forward to use that as much as we can, the best possible way. Also, let me say that we see this as one event, a string of events that will lead us to the next summer. And next summer, hopefully, we'll meet some of you, maybe all of you, here in Belgrade again, because we will be the host for the LIBR 2020 conference. And that is something that is very important for us. We strive for that for 5 years, to do more, and we appreciate everyone who helped us in this road, and some people in the flood as well did put a good word for us that we will say that we shall be more or less acceptable in this place. So come to Belgrade again, stay with us as long as you can. If you have any possible questions, we'll be delighted to relate to any issues that we could be of any interest to you. And if you figure out to say, well, okay, professor, but whom should I read from Serbian literature? Trust me, there are very few people in Serbia that will give you better advice than myself. And as you can see, I do not suffer being too humble. Welcome to Belgrade. You have a very nice conference. Thank you very much for coming.
Restaurant at half past five
in order to be able to get to the National Library at 6 o'clock. So my colleague Sheila and I will be with you the whole day, so we will be guiding you through Belgrade and to these tours. So again, welcome to Belgrade and have a nice conference. So Sheila.
Noela said everything so perfectly. I have nothing more to add. Just if you have any questions or technical issues today or have any questions regarding the day tomorrow, feel free to ask us anytime. We will be here or at the registration desk outside of this room. So have a great conference and thank you for coming. I don't know if I say it right, but good morning. Thank you very much for being here. I really appreciate everyone is leaving his house, his job, to stay with us for 2 days in a very, very important moment, honestly, to my career. Because being in Serbia, it was a dream. So I'm very, very happy that I was, my colleagues really made it happen in my life, because I write about library during wartime, and I wrote about Serbia, about what happened during the war, not in details from translated materials, and it's for me being here, it's like, you know, like you write about something and suddenly you see it and it's very important. This conference is going to start now, and I want to welcome everyone, and I want to really thank the library for hosting this conference and make it easy for us to be here together and start a 2 days conference. We'll start with my colleague Lynch and his colleague and another colleague Sherry Bosch. They will talk to us about the Family Search Wiki, and together we can accomplish more, presenting by, as I said, Lynch and Sherry. And before we start, I just want to make sure that you all listen to this one announcement, because writing local history, it's really a new movement. Before, history was written by the authority. Today, we are writing our local history. And this is a very important movement, because we write it in the social media, we write it in our emails, and there's a group now who are interested in collecting this local history and make the voice of the people, not just of the authority. There is a grant, if you are interested in applying for grant from the British Library, apply for money, to preserve local history or to preserve all materials. There's a grant from the British Library, it's called the Endangered Archives. I will show you the website. You can apply for grants, it's very easy, and I will be very, very happy to help you apply for it. I don't charge money, we give money. So make sure that you can contact me if you are interested, even asking questions. And now we'll start with my colleagues Lynch and Sherry. Thank you very much.
By raise of hand, have any of you heard of Family Search? I'm going to talk specifically about one part of our website, and that is our research wiki. Now, how many of you have used Wikipedia? Anybody use Wikipedia? No? Okay. Good! This is wonderful. Wikipedia is like an encyclopedia that many people can contribute information to. Ours is a research wiki, so it is based on how to do genealogy research, how to do local history research, but ours is vetted and sourced by professional genealogists. So we reach out to the community and say, give us your best information, and then we try to disseminate it or share it with other people around the world. Oops. There we go. So this is what our website looks like, and there's two ways to get there. You're welcome to just click on the search, or when you can do the drop-down menu and get to the wiki that way. So if you just go to the website, it's just the wiki. Thank you. When you come to this page, and this is very small, I could not get it any larger than this. But my example was Serbia, because we are in the beautiful country of Serbia, so of course my example. So when you put that in and you press go, then you get some information. This is the top portion of the screen, and then you would scroll down for more information. And by the way, our website is in 12 languages, unfortunately not Serbian. But you have getting started, like someone has never done any genealogy research before. How do they get started? So they can go here to get started. Many times people come in and they're like, I want to know about my homeland history, or I want to know where my great-grandparents came from. And so these give you instructions on how to get that kind of information and how to do it in a lot of different countries, because it varies. Very quick example, last night a gentleman in our hotel was asking me about family search. He wanted to know more information. And he is from Serbia and did not know what a census was. So I had the opportunity to tell him what a census, and he said that that doesn't happen in Serbia. There's not like a federal or government census every 10 years. But in like Canada, United States, many other countries. So in Serbia, your records are going to be different than they are in France, or in India, or any other country. So there's going to be similarities and then differences, which is why the wiki can really help. You can see here as we scroll down, it shows us more of the country, breaking down into different groups, regions. Then you can see we have some information about the archives here in Serbia. And then we also have helped you actually using our wiki. So if you've never done it before, then there's some instructions on how to just actually use the wiki. Another very helpful tool on the wiki is this selection table. So if you or your patron are looking for a birthday or place, these are types of record sets you would want to look at to find that type of information. Now what I would like to do is invite each of you to actively join and add a page to our wiki. And the instructions are in your papers, but you are welcome to actually talk about your library on our website. And if you need help or assistance, we can do that as well. But as you will see after Russ gives his presentation, as people are looking to learn more about their families, as they're looking more on heritage and culture and the local history, they're going to need to have a source of where to go to find the information. And we are free, so there's no cost, and so it's a very good way to be able to tell your library story, to tell the story of your country, to give information to those around the world. as a little side note, we do also have a social media page at Family Search. There's some information. And if you're interested, we can write an article about your library and talk about it and the resources. And let's see what this is. Go ahead. We continue actively to have scanning materials, scanning cameras in libraries, archives, churches. We work with many different organizations to preserve these wonderful, rare local histories and genealogies and information. Again, our resources are completely free. We are always active looking for partners. So, to partner with your library or to partner with a church to, again, preserve the records. And we have a wonderful catalog that I can talk more about later. And then, let's see, what else do we have? I talked about the wiki. This is my summation. It's almost done. Oh yes, we do have mobile apps that you can have on many devices. And then there's one more. I'm going to end with this information about a study that was done in the United States. Marshall Duke is a psychologist at Emory University, and his wife is also a psychologist, working with children with learning disabilities. And they found something very interesting, and I'm just going to read the quote. "The ones who know a lot about their families tend to do better when they face challenges," she said. Her husband was intrigued and, along with a colleague, Robin, set out to test her hypothesis. They developed a measure called Do You Know scale that asked children to answer 20 questions. The more the children knew about their family story, the stronger their sense of control over their lives, the higher their self-esteem, and the more successfully they believe their families function. The Do You Know scale turned out to be the best single prediction of children's emotional health and happiness. I have found this to be fascinating. There is more research out there about the subject if you're interested. But basically, children that know their heritage, that know their history, who they are, where they came from, they tend to be stronger and more resilient, more self-reliant. And so, again, that's why we feel very passionately about the work we are doing here. Thank you. Or, voila.
Take a DNA test to go ahead and do that. there have been, in a recent study, these are the results of why people in America take a DNA test. There are quite a varied set of reasons. Some just for curiosity, others with an intent question that they're hoping DNA can answer. As Bozina mentioned, one of these is ethnicity, really to learn who am I, what makes me the person that I am. And so to learn where I came from and where my ancestors are from can be a very compelling thing. I also want to mention, I am not a DNA expert. I'm just learning about this resource of DNA for family history. But it has grown so much in the past few years that there is a lot of potential. I also learned in just a little bit of work that I've done personally or helping our patrons at the Family History Library, how much is possible. So I guess at this point, I do know enough that I could talk all day long about this because there is so much involved. So all I can do today is just give you a brief introduction of some of the concepts and information, and we'll refer you to many of the websites where you can get more information. I think it will help to see a TV commercial that might explain, again, some of the motives and some of the trends that we are seeing in America. I think the English in this commercial is quite fast, so if we may have to talk about it in a minute. When it's over.
I've always been interested to learn more about my family roots, and so has my dad. So when I found out through 23andMe that the majority of our family came from Great Britain, I decided to invite him along for a little trip to the English countryside.
Just another day at the office for you, huh?
Just another day, Dad.
Leaving.
Yeah.
Taking pictures.
I'm busy.
TV spot helped do a little bit of explaining both how people are testing to get more information, but also how industries like the travel industry or Airbnb would take advantage of this opportunity well. And so you may see more Americans coming into your libraries now that they have confirmed their ethnicity and have questions about it. So because of that, they may want to know what else they can learn about their family when they're in your area, or what they can learn about your country and the culture for your country. One of the, for me, exciting things that DNA is doing is can help confirm information we learn in traditional sources, something we see in the church record or in the government record, that then also shows up medically or biologically. And I think that then is compelling for people to then study a little more. Okay, I'd like to just show you briefly what information we provide on our Family Search website. We do not promote any particular company or any particular set of products or tests. So we try to just explain the concepts of the biological concepts of MDA, and then let people know what test options are available, what companies they can contact. They would then have to investigate what the cost is and the process for them. And then, we also, for a lot of people, it was easy for them to purchase the kit, take the test, which often is a saliva from your mouth. You just spit in a tube and send the sample of your saliva. For others, it's a cheek swab where you rub against your skin and send that information into a testing company. But then they want to know, what do I do now that I have this information, and what are the next steps? So for that, we try to explain how it could help them with their ethnicity and learn about their homelands, how it might help go through what we call a brick wall, and you get to the end of the line on the pedigree and can't go any further. We tell them about cousin matches, which is a way for them to get in contact with other living people that are their biological relatives, even though they may not know exactly how they're related to that person. And then the chromosome mapping and adoptions. So now we go back. Because there is a lot of information that might be, that the medical community might be familiar with it, but we in the library community don't know, or as hobbyists doing family history wouldn't know, we have a lot of frequently asked questions, or what we call in America the FAQs, and as well as some terminology. So we try to help people know, because there's so many different tests, what these tests are. Then there's the emerging science in haplogroups and chromosomes that we try to have a vocabulary page to help people become familiar with these terms and their definitions and uses. So lastly, I think one of the best pages for additional information is a group called the International Society of Genetic Genealogists. So if you didn't look at any other websites, I think going to the isogg.org website would be the best use of your time, because it's loaded with good information, and which I think has both basic introductions to things, as well as this is where a lot of the experts in the field for genetic genealogy and using family history with genetic science can be found. In the handout, oh, when you pass out the handouts? Again, we have them in English and in Serbian, so take what language works best for you. In the handout, we have quite a few other websites that would be useful resources for you. Okay, so in my limited time, that was the information we wanted to present. I hope it's helpful for you, and as we have discussions about this in the next few minutes, we'll try to answer any questions you might have. Thank you.
Everybody else.